Costa Rica is working hard to reduce its greenhouse gas emissions. By 2050, the country wants to do its share to limit the global temperature rise by 1.5 degrees. An important contribution is made in the coffee sector, as many greenhouse gas emissions are released during cultivation and processing of the beans. Coffee is the second largest source of emissions in Costa Rica's agriculture. Together with our local partners, we are helping 56 coffee mills identify sources of emissions along the coffee value chain, calculate their carbon footprint, and develop concrete measures to reduce emissions. For example, several mills have purchased new and efficient drying ovens, which require up to 27% less biomass. Others have acquired solar panels, lowering their energy consumption by up to 60% and reducing greenhouse gas emissions by over 35%. But there's also plenty of potential for emission reductions in the plantations. Fertilizers cause 60% of emissions in the coffee sector. We have trained coffee growers to use fertilizers in a targeted manner, optimally adapted to the needs of the soil. Also, some coffee growers compost their unused coffee pulp and use it as additional organic fertilizer. Over 3,500 farmers now use low-emission production methods on their farms. All in all, our work with mills and farmers has already saved more than 22,000 tons of CO2. What's special about the project is that Costa Rica is the first country in the world to produce low-carbon coffee. So far, the climate-friendly coffee has been very well received at trade fairs and visits to roasting companies around the world. The coffee is already sold and drunk in Germany and the USA.